To image processing tutorials on DSP. Today we will be looking at bitplane slicing. So bitplane slicing folder is in the image processing DSP 10_image_processing_DSP folder, in the bitplane slicing folder. First we will see the theory. A bitplane slicing, what basically is a bitplane slicing is, bitplane slicing is done on a gray image. So first step will be to convert the color image to gray image. Now this gray image is a 8-bit per pixel image. So each pixel is of 8 bits. So assuming that the first pixel has value 01 00 01 01, so this is the MSB, this is the LSB of that pixel, and this is the MSB of that pixel. So what if we print, or if we send all the values of all the pixels, the LSB values, suppose the 0th bit, I'll call this the 0th bit, then this will be the first bit, then the second bit, and so on. This will be the 7th bit, which is the MSB. So if we send the 0th bit of all the pixels of the entire image, then, and if we save that image as a binary image, where 0 will be interpreted as 0 and 1 will be interpreted as 255 or white, 0 will be interpreted as 0 or black, then the image form will be a bit plane image for the 0th bit, and similarly for the first bit, second bit, and so on, the 7th bit, which is the MSB. Then from the output we can see that the MSB will have the maximum information and the LSB will have the minimum information. And as we move towards upwards in the bit planes, there will be more information in the image. This will be seen. So this is all for theory. So what we basically do is that we have a decimal value which is stored in an integer. We convert it to binary and store it in an array. According to the bit plane, if I want the first plane, I will send only A0. If I want the highest plane, I will send AA. If the value is 1, I will send 255. If the value is 0, I'll send 0. This is how I'll be getting the bit plane image. This is all in the theory. Moving to the code part. To view the code, debug the code, we'll open the code composer studio. Any workspace can be selected. Click on OK. This opens the CCS. Here we'll import the project, import existing project, browse. I have it on the desktop, the image processing DSP folder. Inside this, the bitplane slicing folder, we have to import the PJT file. Click on OK, finish. Here we'll go through the code first. In the image processing functions.c file, I have the bitplane slicing function. This is the bitplane slicing function declaration here. It is a parameterized function having two parameters. One is the component and another is the bitplane. This gives us which bitplane we want. and the component gives us how which grayscale image we have to between slice. We'll come to know more when we go to the function definition. So I'll copy this between slicing, control C, control F for find, control V, and find the function definition. Here I got the function definition for the between slicing. So initially for any image processing technique, the basic thing which we need is an image. We have two options to get that image. One is directly from the camera or other is directly from the PC. So how this happens is in the main, initially I initialize the flash photo. This initializes the entire flash, erases the flash completely. Then I send this command to the camera which is interfaced with the DSP to get the JPEG, capture the JPEG image. JPEG image is a compressed image. Then I send the name of the image to the PC, which is original image, and send the JPEG image captured from the camera. So now on the PC local disk, we have a JPEG image captured from the camera, and the PC can have various images. So now I wait for the DSP waits for the PC to send the image. The PC can send the same image which it has acquired from the camera or any other image which it has on the local drive. This image is then written to the flash of the DSP. Then the DSP sends the number of images which it will be sending. It only sends the number, a digit, which it will be sending after this. So this input image sends the image which is written on the flash. This is just for confirmation or verification that the image which is written on the flash is perfectly the exact replica of the image sent from the PC. After that, these function calls process the image which is on the flash according to the code written in this function and send the output to the PC, which is stored on the PC as a JPEG or a PNG file, and we can view it on the PC. This between slicing function, as we can see, this has two parameters. One is the type of grayscaling which we want, which can be Y, X, N, A, R, G, B, and the bit plane 7654321 0. So this is how this code works. We'll again go to the bit plane slicing function. Here, according to the component and the bit plane, the name of the image is sent and the com select value is set. This com select value is set to convert the color input image obtained from the PC to the gray image according to the method which we want. The method is selected with the component value. So once we get this code, all these if and else if statement just send the name of the image which we are going to send and the component select value is initialized or redefined. After that, we send A or B according to the type of image which we are sending to Python. We send for a 320*240*1 image. This 320*240*1 is a 320 × 240 × 1 image, which each pixel is a 8-bit pixel. Here, according to the com select as explained in the gray and inverse gray folder, the average is computed. This is the averaging. So R plus G plus B by 3. And accordingly for Y, average is calculated. So initially we are converting the color image to a gray image. So each color pixel is converted to a gray pixel. And then this decimal to binary check, this function if we see this function, this decimal to binary check function, what this is doing is it has two parameters, a number and the bit plane. This function is called in the decimal to binary. The number which we are inputting is the average value, which is the gray value of that pixel, and the bit plane which we want as input. So this function the n contains the average value or the grayscale value, which can be ranging from 0 to 255, and this is giving us the bit plane. So initially we are initializing this array to 0, and then we are converting this n, which is a integer, and storing it into a array AI. This is just converting from decimal to binary. This code here is for converting the decimal value of the gray pixel, which is stored in n, to binary. And this binary is information is stored in the array A. And according to the bit plane which we want, can be from 0 to 7, according to the function call here, from 0 to 7. The value in the array AI is sent. So the value in the array AI can be either 0 or 1. So again, going to the bit plane slicing function, here according to the component the LSF is selected and this formula is applied, so that we get the gray value of the pixel. Then this function is used, which gives us the 0 or 1, whether the bit plane, the value of the bit which we want on the bit plane is 0 or 1. And if it is 1, we send 255. If it is 0, we send a 0. So this basically, this function decimal to binary check, this has two inputs, average and bit plane. Average is a value which is obtained from this line of code, which is a gray value. This average is ranging from 0 to 255. This bit plane will be ranging from 0 to 7. I convert this average value, the function converts this average value to a binary value. This is a decimal value. Then that binary value is a 8-bit value. So the according to the bit plane from 0 to 7, the 8-bit, the value on that bit is selected and compared. If it is 1, then we send a 255. If it is a 0, we send a 0. And this is for the entire image. So here, this is how we get the bit plane slice image of a color image. So color image is converted to a gray image, and then it is bit plane sliced. Now we'll run this code. We'll build this code first, checking for any errors and warnings. There are 7 warnings here, but these are all right. So we can run, we can debug this code by clicking on the bug icon. Debug erases the flash of DSP and then loads the code. This flash erase text is because we are using the flash programming. Now I'll run this code. And on the Python side, on the PC side, I have to run the Python script. So the Python script is in the bitplane slicing folder itself. This BC0703 underscore camera is a Python file. I have to open it using edit with idle, right click and edit with idle. I will check the baud rate and the COM port. The baud rate is 460800 and the COM port is 5. You can see from the previous videos that how to check the COM port using device manager. I'll again show you in the device manager. In the ports, the COM port is 13. So we'll change to 13. The baud rate. The safest baud rate to use is 115200. We'll check if the baud rate is set on the DSP side first. The DSP side SCIA is used for communication with PC and the baud rate is 09. 09 is for 460800. So we'll be setting it to 115200, which is 27. We'll be saving it. Once we save it, we need to terminate and relaunch so that whatever changes we have made are incorporated on the DSP. So we'll terminate and relaunch this. And change the baud rate here to 115200. Here, the image which will be processed will be a PC image. I can change this to the image underscore name so that the image which will be processed will be a image from the camera. So here, I'll run the code on the DSP side. I'll close the device manager. And run the code on the Python side after checking. This starts the serial communication. This is the original image which we have received, which the PC has received. This is the PC image. This is the input image which we have received from the DSP, which is similar to the PC image. But this gives us an idea of what is stored on the flash of the DSP, if it is correctly the PC image or not. So now we are getting the bitplane output. This is the gray image, the gray component of the original image. And these are the bitplane outputs which we are getting. This is the 7th, which has the maximum information by 7, the highest bit, the MSB. And as we move to the lower bits, you can see the lowest bit, the least bit, the Y1. This is not the least bit, the second LSB, Y1, has nearly very less information. Y0, similarly, comparatively very less information, Y1. And as we go ahead, Y2, the information on the bit increases. Y3, you can see the image. Not very clearly, but the information is increasing. Y4, as we move above, the information increases. Y5, Y6, and Y7. So we can clearly say that this statement from theory and the outputs, that MSB contains the maximum information and LSB contains the minimum information, can be verified from the outputs clearly. As we have seen the outputs, interpreted the outputs, seen the theory, seen the code and explanation. Now if we want to close the code and the plug out the DSP, power of the DSP, we should not directly power off the DSP. We should come out of the debug mode using terminate, and now we can power off the DSP. That is all for today.